A common pattern is using a forever block with an if block inside. To better understand this, we'll look at having an if block with a forever inside. Here in Scratch, I've written two scripts. The first one on the left should look familiar. Here I play a note. Then I have a forever if. Forever, I'm going to check if the key space, that's the space key, is pressed. And if it is, then I'm going to play the drum one for a quarter of a beat. So if I'm running this script, I hear the note 60 play, and then whenever I press the space key, I should hear the drum. Okay, let's stop that one and look at the next. On this one, again, it starts by playing a note 60, and then one time, it's gonna check if the key space, or the space key, is pressed. Then forever, it'll play this drum one for a quarter beat. So it only checks if the space key is pressed once, and then forever it will play this drum. So if I start this script, it'll run quickly and stop running. So it plays the note and then checks if the space key is pressed, and it's not. So I never hear the drum beat. If I press the space bar and then I start this script, then it'll play the note, the key will be pressed, and forever it'll keep playing this drum. So let me try it. I'm holding down the space key, and now I'll double click this script. Even if I let go of the space key, it's not checking that anymore. It's just in this forever playing this drum. Let me stop it. So in the one on the left, where forever was on the outside, it forever repeated this test of if the space key was pressed. The one on the right only checked if the space key was pressed once, but if it was, then forever it played this drum. Forever and if can be pretty tricky, so I wanted to show you two different examples where we use them in a different order. Really, you're only ever going to want to use the one on the left. That one's going to be pretty helpful.